This episode is brought to you by Paras Catering and Events. Check out their FB page and see all the excellent customer feedback regarding their delicious food, great service, and elegant styling. You can reach them at 0917-844-4470 and look for Ms. Jubian Paras. What is up mga ka-Life Fit? Welcome back to a long overdue car vlog. Kasi I think over the past seasons, madalas ano eh, either nasa on-site location or sa studio. So gone are the days na nagsushoot ako sa loob ng sasakyan in a moving one. Pero yun nga. Ano lang, just wanted to ano, hindi naman ranting to or what. Pero I had an experience siguro a few days ago, magkasunod. Pasensya na sa ano ha, maalog na sa expressway. On our road to another video shoot for an episode in BGC. So yun, anyways, I had an experience siguro a few days ago na I think I take it as a compliment.
Nice.
Dalawang sunod. Nakapila ako sa ATM machine sa isang convenience store, tapos so happened na yung ATM machine was being inspected by a technician. Sakto na yung bubuksan yung machine, pero ako sana mag-withdraw ako. So nakita niya ako. Parang sir, mag-withdraw po kayo, sabi niya sa akin. Pwede ba? Sabi ko ganoon. Kasi medyo lumamadali lang po. Sure, pwede naman po, sabi niya. O di nag-withdraw na ako. Tapos yung pala, tinitingnan niya ako. Head to foot.
Pwede na!
Sinasabi niya. Ang sinabi niya, sir, ilang years na ho kayong nag-gym? Sabi niya gano'n. So, una, by saying that, ibig sabihin, from the point of view of a ordinary bystander, obvious na nag-gym ako. Tapos, ang sunod na question niya, paano po mag-maintain ng ganyang malaking physique? Kasi dati po nag-gym din ako, sabi niya. Natigil lang po ako. Hindi, syempre, andun ako doon sa part na, actually, pwede ka naman bumalik anytime. Nothing is preventing you from going back into the ulit. The grind, sabi ko lang. Medyo chit-chat kami konti, tapos sinabi ko lang sa kanya na go back easily, gradually, wag mong niyang biglain yung training niya. And babalik siya sa dati niyang physique. Sabi nga niya, ganyan din katawa ko sa sir dati, yung parang bouncer. Parang bouncer, sabi. So medyo ano naman ako na natawa naman ako doon. Pero I take it as a compliment. So okay na, umalis na ako. Tapos another one, the same day, siguro after an hour, meron naman ako na-encounter na tindero. Kasi bumili ako ng pakwan along the road. Kinailangan namin sa catering. So I had to do an errand. So bumili ako ng pakwan. Yung mga nagtitim na lang along the road kasi tapos na yung market time, so hindi na ako makakabili sa palengke. So naghanap ako along the road. So may nakita ako. Ngayon yung nagtitinda, ganun ang naging comment din niya, sir, matagal na kayo nag-gym, no sir? Kasi malaki ataw niya sir, yung mga braso niya malaki. So
paano masabi?
Again, I take it as a compliment. Sinabi ko na lang, actually sir, nag-maintain na lang po ako. Pero dati lumalabang ka, sabi niya sa akin ganun. So munting na po ako lumaban, pero hindi po natuloy. Sabi niya, pwede ka po bumalik sir, bata ka pa naman, sabi niya sa akin. Ay, sir, kung hindi niyo po naitatanong, 42 na po ako, sabi ko ganun. So again, those kinds of reactions mga ka-Life Fit, I take it as a compliment, and it's a testament of the result you get from training. Diba? Consistent training for so many years. And in my case, alam ko matagal ko na sinasabi to sa inyo mga ka-Life Fit. I've been training for more than 20 years na. So, ngayon ko nakikita yung added benefits of training. And naalala ko when I was reviewing a few days back yung mga previous episodes sa channel, I was able to do 2 episodes of The Ideal Physique, part 1 and part 2. So, this is part 3 ng mga ka-Life Fit. So, yun. Yun yung nag-ignite nun. So, ano ba ang ideal physique? The last time that I made the episode is yung ideal physique is yung physique na what's gonna be comfortable for you. Diba? Kung ano yung swak sa ano mo, kung ano yung swak sa pakiramdam mo, diba? Kasi there's not one ideal physique na pwedeng i-set sa'yo or i-tag sa'yo or parang hindi pwedeng ibang tao yung magsabi sa'yo, oh, ito dapat ang physique mo, ito. It's still up to you, mga ka-life. So, fast forward, I think that was a year ago or more than a year ago. Yun pa rin ba ang perception ko about the ideal physique? Lumipas ang ilang buwan na ba? Yeah. When I changed the way I trained, kasi before I was still doing push pull, I was still training 4 to 5 times a week, so medyo madalas pa rin. Ngayon medyo, dahil nga 42 na ako, turning 43 na ako in a few weeks, mga ka-life. So parang nag-modify or nagta-transform or nagmo-morph yung training adaptability ko. I can't train as much as before. And I think I discussed this in a previous episode, previously uploaded episode about the changes I made in my training routine. So I can't train as often as before kasi nga my recovery is not as fast as before. Tapos ang dami kong ring binago sa the way I lifted, the number of sets I'm doing, the number of reps I'm doing, the kinds of reps I'm doing, the weights I'm lifting, ang dami naging changes eh. So with that, ang physique ko ba am I still there? Ako minado ko over the months, I developed a dad bod kahit papaano. Medyo nakikita ko na yung bubble gut ko. Not that it's wrong or body shaming or something, di ba? Pero kung if I compare my physique a few years back, I was significantly leaner before. Actually, marami na nakakalata na ayan, even my producer said na, "Uy, ganyan ako na. Umano na yung chan mo." Well, at first I said to myself na is that a bad thing? Diba? Is that a bad thing na nagkakaroon ako ng dad bod or nagiging bouncer look na ba ako, kaya sabi nung isang naka-observe sa akin, am I going into that direction na? Well, siguro initially I said to myself, "Oh, that's not good. Kasi being in a fitness channel, di ba? I should conform to these kinds of standards. Dapat may abs ka, dapat shredded ka, dapat lean ka, dapat yung mukha mo hindi siya shoma, hindi siya monay, di ba? Maraming ganun eh. Kasi nga, come to think of it, are those standards that have been set for us, di ba, initially? Or should we conform to those standards? Yun ba yung ideal physique? Pag sinabing fitness influencer, automatic ito na yung itsura niya. 'Di ba? I've seen a lot of influencers online din na are not following that kind of norm anymore. Specifically si Miss Miranda Cohen, medyo nag-stand out siya sa akin kasi she's not a typical fitness influencer na babae. Kasi usually pag sinabi ng babae na fitness influencer, sexy. You know the yung stats, 'di ba? Yung vital stats nila. Sexy, trim, di sila thick, 'di ba? Pero hindi eh. Pag titingnan mo siya, she's quite different from the rest. But and yet, she has a following, she's a fitness influencer. So what's not stopping her from being one, 'di ba? So ganun ba 'yon? Porque if you want to be something, if you want to be someone, should you conform to the standards of that persona you're aiming for, diba? So it gives us this question in our mind na the ideal physique is dictated by what factors? Well, I guess ultimately it's dictated by what you feel, what you want for yourself. If you're not feeling good about yourself, then do something about it, diba? Don't blame other people or don't blame other factors na why you're feeling this way. Pero if you like the way you look, I think the only guiding principle now is hindi ka dapat, you're not bordering dun sa mga, dun sa unhealthy side. I know a lot of influencers that's promoting this kind of ano, this kind of behavior, this kind of lifestyle. Si Nicolado Avocado, di ba? Yung I think his videos are more of mukbang videos, di ba? He's obese, di ba? He's obese, and yet I feel na I think he likes what he looks right now. I think dati hindi naman siya ganun eh. Siguro I don't know what led him to being this ano this way. I don't know if it's the money ba. The people want him to be this way, di ba? Is it? I don't know. Pero siguro, di ba? Pero yun nga eh. This episode is brought to you by Waking. Scan my QR code or use my personal link when you shop online or when you buy at any Waking store nationwide. Get a chance to win freebies and discounts from Life Fit 40. A lot of other influencers have also called him out because of this. One specifically si Greg Doucette. Greg Doucette is a fitness influencer also, a former bodybuilder. I'm not sure if he's still actively competing, pero he was actively competing as a bodybuilder for so many years na rin, and he's been calling out Nicolado Avocado for so many times. Nico lang, o yun. For so many. Instances in the past, kasi nga, he's promoting the it's okay being this way, being obese, eating whatever you want. There's a fine line kasi between that eh, na okay, you want to feel this way, okay, fine, that's you. Pero don't force anyone to just to follow your own path, kasi it might lead to to what you call this. Ang iniiwasan naman natin is yung may namamatay because of this eh. Also, a lot of people then fitness influencers online na they desperately want to look a certain way na they would resort to using performance enhancement drugs na para they could achieve the look that the internet is dictating them to be to appear, di ba? Kasi kung hindi ka if you don't look a certain way sa online, you're not gonna have followers, di ba? Doon ako medyo hindi agree, di ba? If you want to be an influencer pero you don't look a certain way, would that stop you from being one? I think not. Dapat hindi. As long as you can share the knowledge, you can share the experiences, and you know you will make a difference in other people's lives because of what you experience, I think that at the end of the day, yan naman yung importante, di ba? Ba't ba tayo nasa social media in the first place? To be famous? Or to gain attention, di ba? Siguro yung mga yun, byproducts na lang yun eh. To have a profession, to be monetized, di ba? Ang daming daming byproducts eh. Pero I think at the end of the day, your content should matter. Di ba? Your content should matter. And that content will either make or break somebody's life down the line, di ba? Ako natutuwa ako pag may nagko-comment or may nagsasend ng message sa Facebook page ko na asking how to start, how to go into the fitness journey kahit matanda na sila, kahit 40s na sila. I feel na kahit papaano in my own small way, I am able to have an effect kahit papaano. Actually, this started out just as a hobby lang naman eh. Kasi when I turned 40 two or more years ago, yun lang eh. But I just wanted to say to I said to myself na how can I make my being 40 significant eh? I went back to episode 1, season 1, episode 1. Ano yung naging dahilan ko why I started life in 40? So yun nga, I go back to the why. It's because there are other people like me na nasa 40s na who are at the crossroads na are we willing to continue doing the things that we're doing in the past, di ba? Does it matter? Will it matter? Yun. So yun, some things to ponder while driving. Actually, ilang weeks ko na itong gustong i-share din sa inyo mga ka-life it. And, yun, dad bod or not, bouncer or ano, or not, diba? Will compete, I don't know. Will trim down in the next few months, I'm not sure. Pero, what I know is, this thing that's going on, this thing we started out, mga ka-life it, going 3 years na rin, or more, mga ka-life it, this will matter along the line, and I'm so happy and grateful for all the followers, the viewers, my friends, my family, who's been supporting this channel for so many years already, and we'll be coming out with a lot more relatable topics, not topics that are that are just purely entertainment. Yung something na na we can relate to and we could have a positive impact also on our daily lives, mga kalife. So there, I think mga 30 kilometers to go pa going to BGC. Nandito pa ako sa expressway, pero yun nga, watch out for the coming episodes for more content like this. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my fitness channel, my YouTube channel, my Facebook page, Life in 40. Don't forget to hit the bell button so you'll be notified for all future content. Again, a huge shout out and thank you to all our sponsors. Their links are in the description down below. So we'll be seeing you in the next episode. Stay safe always, mga ka-life it.